Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the first meeting of Session 6 of the Economy and Fair Work Committee. I'm Colin Beattie, MSP for Midlothian North and Musselburgh. As the oldest member of the committee, I have the pleasure of convening this meeting for the first two items of business. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome everybody, and I look forward to working with you all in this committee. Before we move to the first item on the agenda, I would like to remind everyone present to switch mobile phones to silent. I note that no apologies have been received. So move to agenda one, and the first agenda item requires each of us to declare any interest we have relevant to the work of this committee. Background information is provided in the Declaration of Interest paper, which is paper one. I will declare my interest first, and since this committee covers tourism, I will mention that I'm a trustee director of the National Mining Museum of Scotland. I'll now go around to other members in alphabetical order, and I will simply call out your name and give you the opportunity to declare your interest as necessary. So I'll call Claire Baker.
Thank you. I would like to declare that I am a member of Unite the Trade Union, and I'm also a member of the Cooperative Party. I'm also elected as a Labour and Cooperative Party MSP.
Thank you. I'll call Alexander Burnett.
Thank you, Convener. I refer members to my entry in the Register of Members' Interests, and specifically I declare an interest as an owner and manager of property, including agricultural, residential and commercial lettings, recreational and sporting usage and forestry, as a shareholder in a construction, development and house building group and a renewable energy company, and as the holder of remunerated positions in companies related to those areas.
Thank you. I'll call Jimmy Halker-Johnson.
Thank you, Convener. No specific in relation to the work of this committee, but I am partner in a farming business of J. Hapra Johnson & Sons in Orkney and own a number of properties.
Thank you. I'll call Fiona Hislop.
For the purposes of this committee, I just want to note that I was Economy Secretary and Fair Work Secretary in the Scottish Government from February 2020 to May 2021.
Thank you. I'll call Gordon MacDonald.
Thank you, Convener. I have no relevant interest that I need to declare. However, I just want to mention part of Historic Environment Scotland now that we have the tourism brief as well.
Thank you. I'll call Lorna Slater.
Per my register of interest, I recently worked as Orbital Marine Support, which is a tidal energy company, therefore received my final pay during my time as an MSP. I'm also the trustee of the Edinburgh Remakery, which is a social enterprise I am a member of.
Thank you. Nicole Colin Smith.
Thank you. Can I declare that, although there are only voluntary parts of my declaration of interest, that I'm a member of the GMB Trade Union, a member of the Unite Trade Union, I'm also a member of the Cooperative Party as a Scottish Labour and Cooperative Party MSP.
Thank you. And finally, I'll call Michelle Thompson.
Good morning, everybody. I too refer members to my register of interests. I receive income from residential buy-to-let properties, and I'm also a shareholder in a property management company, but only receive a benefit in kind in the form of life cover but no other income. As a former MP, I've been asked to continue in a role as an ambassador for a Westminster all-party parliamentary group for fair business banking, for which I receive no income.
Thank you. I'll now move on to agenda item two, and that's our task to choose a convener. The procedure is explained in the choice of convener paper, which is paper two. Now, the Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish Labour Party are eligible for nomination as convener of this committee. Can I have a nomination from Scottish Labour?
Could I nominate Claire Baker as convener?
Thank you. Do we agree to choose Claire Baker as our convener? No one dissents. I congratulate Claire Baker on her appointment, and I will swiftly vacate the chair and hand over to her.
Thank you very much, Colin, and thanks to everybody for giving me your support to be convener of this important committee. I'm looking forward to the role. As we move through the pandemic, obviously there's been a huge impact on our economy and on our well-being, and the committee have a big part to play, I believe, in building Scotland's recovery and working with members across Parliament.
Oh,
Colin,
are you there?
Want to achieve that, I am required to appoint a deputy convener. It's been agreed by the Parliament that only members of the Scottish National Party are eligible for nominations as deputy convener, and so I invite members to make a nomination.
Can I nominate Colin Beattie as the deputy convener of this committee?
Thank you, Gordon. Is everyone agreed with that nomination? That's great. Thank you very much. And I look forward to working with you, Colin. I'm sure we'll have an interesting session ahead of us. And the fourth item on the agenda is the legacy paper. This morning, which comes from the former Economy, Energy and Fair Work Committee, who were in session five. And the committee is being asked to note the legacy report. I would like to thank all the members of that previous committee for a very detailed report that will give us a good basis for the work ahead of us in this session. And I would ask members to note the report and agree that we can discuss it in a later agenda item. That's great, thank you. And agenda item five is we'll take our existing business in private. So I'm asking you to agree that consideration of item six will be in a private session for this. So are we all agreed? That's great, thank you very much. So as agreed, we'll now move to private session, and I'll allow a few minutes for members to switch to the other platform. So thank you for your time this morning. And I close the meeting.